now, our country whipping bout is coming up. I'll turn the mic over to Joe Ranelli.
This is the country whipping match. One fall, 15-minute time limit. In the ring at this time, from Lake Dallas, 262 pounds, the modern-day warrior, Kerry Von Erich. And his second this evening, none other than the fabulous Bruiser, Brody. Entering the ring, the other contestant from Atlanta, Georgia, 252 pound Freebird, Terry Gordy. His second this evening will be Michael Hayes, Bronco Lubitsch, the referee. They are free to use the whips any way they want once the match begins. Bronco Lubitsch, your referee.
Joe Nelly with the introduction as the excitement continues now, and this crowd is really buzzing. As every bout is a main event tonight, and this is no exception, the country whipping bout, Kerry versus Hayes, Brody in Kerry's corner, Gordy in Hayes' corner. Gordy, fresh from a tour in Japan, he's just back. And the leather belts are in hand. Kerry's ready for his right now. The men can use the belt as they wish, whipping, choking, wrapping it around their fist in brass knuckles fashion. Any way they can think of. And Bronco Lubitsch will have his hands full. The seconds being Brody and Gordy. Understand, Chris Adams and John Mantell will be out to chat with us during our television main event, which is for the Texas Heavyweight Championship. Been a few weeks since we've seen Terry Gordy, just returning from the Orient. Ring the bell, here we go. How would you like to have to be in this? Kerry drawing first blood, and Hayes leaps to the floor. Listen to this crowd. And Brody throws in right back in. Hayes wants out. Brody's got him again. There's no escaping. 15,000 people on their feet. Giving Hayes the whipping that he's wanted to. But now Hayes turns the table. Slapping, whipping. It's unmerciful. What about Gordy picks up the belt. Hayes has lost it. And Kerry wraps his around the neck. Hayes being choked now, he's really in trouble. Gordy tosses Michael's belt back to him, and Hayes swats Kerry across the face again. This is just vicious. Have you ever seen anything like it? Hayes was expecting to throw Kerry across. Kerry came back instead with the belt. Gordy and Brody on the floor. We saw Hayes outside a minute ago getting thrown right back in. No sooner than his feet hit the pavement. Kerry again choking Michael Hayes now. All of the Freebirds in action tonight, all of the Von Erichs in action tonight in various bouts, including all together in the six-man event. And it's Hayes and Kerry both on their knees. And now Hayes will be choking Kerry for the next few seconds. Hayes using his fist now. Kerry's in all kinds of trouble. Kerry is putting his belt around his foot. Got him pinned. Takes the right leg out. And Hayes is down beltless. Kerry now throws his belt away and uses the fist. One, two, and Hayes kicks out. That is our first pin attempt of the bout. And Hayes really caught Terry with an uppercut. Both belts laying in the ring. Terry off the rope, clothesline, and down goes the modern-day warrior. Hayes has dazed himself. Both men are down. Terry Gordy dancing around, agitating the crowd. Hayes has got his belt. Terry now has his. Hayes wraps his belt with the buckle showing around his hand, and he got Kerry with it. Oh, he caught him in the forehead. This is all legal. Kerry now coming back. It seems like each time that Kerry's had a clean shot at Hayes, someone's been there to interfere. But tonight it's Gordy and Brody to try and keep things clean, at least from their own points of view. What Gordy does may not be clean to you. Hayes has got Kerry choked now. Look at Gordy out there, yelling at the crowd, parading around. And it is noisy in here. Michael Hayes has been choking Kerry. Kerry has taken the belt away from him. That's Hayes' belt that he's got. But Hayes throws him into the corner and the belt hits the floor. Hits the ring floor. Hayes out. Drives Kerry down. And look at Hayes.
5 minutes.
Wants to slam him and does so. Hayes on the center rope. High and down. Elbow in the midsection, and Kerry really was hurt on that. One, two. Kerry kicks out and throws Hayes almost to the floor. Gordy was there to keep it from falling, and Kerry's got the belt again. The marks are showing on Hayes' back now. This is a bout that these men will feel for a long time, both emotionally and physically. Now here's Gordy speaking in. Hayes distracting the referee. Brody is now chasing Gordy. Hayes has got Kerry. In a clothesline fashion. Two. Three. Kerry wins.
In 6 minutes and 13 seconds, the winner of the match, Kerry Von Erich.
Freebird Terry Gordy tried to interfere while Hayes distracted the referee, but it all backfired because here came Brody. And after Brody chased Gordy out of the way, Brody and Kerry got the belt in a clothesline fashion and took Michael Hayes down for the count of three. Look out! Hayes has got Brody. Gordy's got Kerry. Kerry's been thrown to the floor, and Hayes is really going to town on Brody. He's got the belt around his neck. The belt around his neck, and Brody is in trouble while Gordy has disposed of Kerry. There's Kerry on the floor, and Gordy's got him by the hair. Gordy is bleeding like everything. And it is utter chaos. Here comes Gordy back in the ring with a thumb in the air to get a do. Flying in the air, and Gordy has got some kind of chokehold on. I've never seen this before. Must be something he learned in Japan. Here's Kerry back in, and just in time. Oh, no telling what the Freebirds would have done. What was their intent? I've never seen anything like that. Some kind of unusual chokehold. And maybe Gordy learned that in Japan, but like I say, their intent was wicked there, and Kerry got in just in time. We'll be back for more of all this when Saturday Night Wrestling from the Convention Center continues. Well, what has seemed like a very short time to you there during the station break has actually been about a 10 or 12 minute intermission here in the building. It got pretty wild in the back after that last event, and I don't know what may happen. I'll try and find out some things from Jimmy Garvin, but first, you've got a big First Blood bout coming up this week.
I thought that it was fantastic what Brother Michael did to that big goofball Bruiser Brody, okay? I thought that was fantastic, but let's get things straight and in order here. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, you are looking at the American Heavyweight Champion. American Heavyweight Champion tomorrow. Now, First Blood, Dallas, Brother Michael and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, the best looking man in the world today, are gonna be going against Kevin Von Erich and Kerry Von Erich. Well, first of all, Kevin Von Erich is still gonna be bleeding on Friday when I get finished with him tonight. So figure that out for yourself, ladies and gentlemen. And speaking of gentlemen, who do we have? Michael. Come here, Michael. Nabe, Nabe, brother. Congratulations. I think you guys did a fantastic job.
Hands, I got some blood on my hands.
Get out of here, Michael Rance. I'll talk to him.
You know what I'm talking about? We got some blood on our hands. And whether y'all like it or not,
go with it, baby.
Hey, I'm talking about Georgia is here to stay. Now, you see my main brother I'm talking about, Bam Bam, Terry Gordy.
Yeah, I loved it too, baby. I loved it.
He came back from Japan. What do you want?
Get out of the frame, man. Get out of the frame, all right?
You know, take a long walk on a short bridge. You know something, Jimmy? Me and Terry here, Bam Bam, we got a match coming up Monday night with Chris Adams and Kerry Von Erich.
Right.
right. You know, warm me up. What I'm interested in is me and you Friday night against Kevin and Kerry.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And the only way that you can win the match is to make the guy bleed. I'm talking about First Blood. Now, the only reason that we are world champions,
tell them why we're world champions,
is because we was brought up to be champions. We've been champions all our lives, man. That's why we're world champions today. Hey, we are the six-man world champions because there's nobody in the world. There's nobody in Texas. There's nobody.
This would happen. Bruiser Brody still.
Look out.
Brody with a chair that Gordy threw in, still covered with blood. Bruiser Brody, a wild, gory situation.
I got news for you and everybody else. It's not going to be Chris Adams and Kerry Von Erich Monday night in Fort Worth. It's going to be Bruiser Brody and Kerry Von Erich, and there's going to be some butt-kicking, and I promise it.
Thank you.
All right. Bruiser Brody evidently is going to take the place of Chris Adams in what was supposed to be a tag bout at the Coliseum. Now, I guess, going to be all four men in the ring at the same time. We will be back to digest all of this and have the Texas Heavyweight Championship in just a moment.
Country Acres Estates presents a...
This is the television main event for the Texas Heavyweight title. Best 2 out of 3 falls, 30-minute time limit. Introducing first from Atlanta, Georgia, 280 pounds, the challenger, Terry Gordy. And from Denton County, 252 pounds, the Texas heavyweight champion, David Von Erich. Jerry Owens, the referee.
That didn't take long. This is absolute chaos tonight. Everything has gotten out of hand. Gordy has got the Texas title belt and hit David with it, who isn't even out of his ring jacket yet. Gordy and David Von Erich to the Texas title, our television main event, best 2 of 3 falls. Gordy with an elbow. Lands his head into the turnbuckle. And this is a wild night, and we are just getting started. David turns the tables. And he really popped it. John Mantell is on his way to ringside. I'll get our interview mic ready as Gordy takes a trip across the ring the hard way. Leg scissors, and across he goes.
Great head scissors. Mark, what fantastic action here tonight, Tarrant County Convention Center. I'm so happy to be here. So happy to see so many people here. What great matches. This should prove to be a good one right here. Terry hot off a Japanese tour. David, of course, on a very hot streak. Fantastic match. Applying pressure to the head, trying to wear him down.
Some kind of sleeper it looked like, but I don't know what that thumb was that he was using when he took Brody down a minute ago.
Yeah, it appeared to be some type of sleeper. Mark, the Orient's known for various type of holds, and it's hard to tell what that was.
David dragging Gordy across the ring with his head down and the leg scissors. What would you say, about 15,000 here tonight?
Oh, I think so. Great crowd here tonight. Enthusiastic, ready to see some world-class wrestling.
Every bout a main event. 3 title events right here on this week's show for you. And Gordy and David continue to get rougher.
Yeah, drops the knee across the head. That'll slow anybody up, Mark.
The Freebirds wound up tighter than an 8-day clock tonight. David defends the right. Hey, Gordy in the rope.
Got him tied up. Able to go to kicking him now.
Now, Vicious goes with the right across the head.
And gotta be careful here, Mark. You don't get carried away and get disqualified. So often you'll get carried away and just go crazy and get disqualified. Now, Jerry will calm him down a little bit.
Now, Johnny, you were in the back when Brody came back after that altercation. A tremendous amount of blood all over him and everybody else.
Terrible.
And we heard what he had to say when he came out with Kerry. All four in the ring. More on that when we get a chance. Look out. Here they come. Paid Canyon now, is it? David on the floor. This is a best 2-3 ball bout. The winner of this ball does not win the match.
Takes all your momentum away, Mark, when you get thrown out of the ring like that.
Brody's got him. Wants to suplex him over that rope. Back in. Brody's doing.
Suplex into the ring.
And I think Gordy hit hard, too.
I think they both hit hard on that one. That's not a perfectly done suplex, Mark. Both men could be laid there for a long time.
Many of the fans on their feet again, urging their man to get back on their feet.
Gordy wasn't hitting with bare bone, Mark. Working on the damaged part, Mark. That's the idea of wrestling. Wear down a part of the body, whether it's an arm, a leg, or a head. Wear it down. Work on it till the opponent wants to give up.
David lost the handle on the leg the first time, but still caught him on the knee.
Yep.
Does it again and held on and caught him even worse. And now he's tying up that toe, bending it around.
That puts pressure, Mark, on 2 points, the ankle and the knee. You apply pressure to both areas.
This is just the first fall of our television main event for the Texas Heavyweight Championship. I'm Mark Durant with Johnny Mantell at ringside. David trying for the pin there.
Yeah. It's hard to pin a man with just his legs, Mark. You got to tie up one of his arms or his shoulders or his neck or something to keep those shoulders flat to the mat.
5 minutes.
David's doing the right thing right now, just wearing the man down.
David close the north door.
Knocks the hand away and comes down on the knee, and Gordy in pain yet another time.
There again, same thing, Mark, applying pressure to the knee and the ankle.
Strong, rough wrestlers, David Von Erich and Gordy, going for the roughest belt of all the Texas titles. A belt that symbolizes a roughhouser.
Gordy pulling on the neck. Trying to get David to loosen up on his leg a little bit to get it free. Mark, there's a lot of hard work to get into the ring like these two men are. It's a long road to get where these two are, fighting for the Texas heavyweight title. The long, hard road.
And, of course, the winner for this belt will work three times as hard tonight, being the television main. Now David's hung in the ropes. Look out. Gordy is in a daze and doesn't see it. And David is free again. But Gordy's there now.
Gordy's such a big, powerful man, Mark. Kick and miss.
And Gordy backed out of the way.
A few cobwebs in his head, didn't quite get up and have the speed of that drop kick he needed.
Gordy misses with the elbow. Leg take down
right
by David.
Right back to the leg. Right back to the leg, Martin.
And the toe hold stretched around the midsection. There is one of the signs in the crowd tonight, one of many.
Not a sign.
David Von Erich yelling at the crowd that he is going to win the belt as it continues to have big Terry Gordy in agony. Gordy reaching around for a handful of hair in the referee sees it.
David working hard on that leg, wearing down the knee joint.
Chanting, we want the claw. Gordy's got a hand in the face, though.
Yeah. David let go of the leg.
David reaches up. The Von Erich iron claw. Gordy paralyzed on his feet. Jerks David down and look out. Mantell here helping David Von Erich as Gordy parades around the ring to the roar of the booing fans. Well, that is four times tonight that I've had to bail out so far. David back in, Gordy waiting ahead of the turnbuckle. And this is just the first fall of all this.
Yes. Two more falls of this, Mark. Right now, Terry's wearing him down. Terry's got the upper hand at this time.
Gordy.
So strong. Body slam.
From the shoulder with that body slam. A kick in the middle of the back.
Could be it, Mark.
One, two, three.
That's
the first ball.
In 9 minutes, the winner of the first ball, David Von Erich.
David Von Erich with a 1-2-3. He's up one fall. John Mantell, thank you for coming out.
Thank you, Mark. I enjoyed it. What a great fall. Congratulations to David. One more fall, and he'll retain the Texas Heavyweight Championship.
All right. Thank you, John Mantell. From the Tarrant County Convention Center in downtown Fort Worth, you're watching the Labor Day Supercar.
More.
David Von Erich up one fall here for the Texas title. Gordy is out amongst the fans, and he'd better be careful out there. There he is. He is not the most popular man in this building right now. And David Von Erich just encouraging the crowd to continue their Go Home Freebirds chant. I have never seen non-stop wildness like we've had tonight. I've been through many wild situations in the world of professional wrestling, but this has been going on now for better than an hour. And like I say, we're just getting started. All of the events are going to be taped tonight, and as Saturday Night Wrestling goes to 2 hours beginning next week, you'll be able to see the other exciting main events in front of this mob as special features in weeks to come. So be looking forward to the events from tonight. Uh-oh, here comes Freebird Buddy Roberts as Gordy has David in the corner. And like I say, it's not simmering down yet. Gordy dancing around like a professional boxer. But David throws Gordy into the corner, upside down. He's hanging there. And David moves right in to take advantage of the opportunity. If David wins this fall, he is the Texas champion again. Gordy being counted unmercifully in an upside down position. And now David riding him around the back and trying to get rid of him. As I look around this building, there's Buddy Roberts. We set a record last time we were here, and we have more people tonight. And this place is packed. Fans now chanting Baldy to the benefit of Buddy Roberts. As Gordy tries to stay with us, putting one of his arms up around the neck. But David continuing the hold. Jerry Usher checking to see if Gordy is still with us. And that just allows David to reinforce that sleeper. We've seen Gordy use some type of sleeper that I'm unfamiliar with, perhaps something he learned during his tour in Japan on Bruiser Brody earlier. And that has resulted in absolute chaos, calling for a change in the card Monday night. as what we thought was Kerry and Adams versus Gordy and Hayes in a tag is now Gordy and Hayes versus Kerry and Brody, all four men in the ring at the same time. David now, after being belted in the eyes, is over against the ropes. Gordy still dazed in the center of the ring. Roberts trying to bring him back by yelling and pounding on the ring. There's Roberts over there. And it's David who comes back first. Gordy must win this fall to draw even. But whatever it is plenty bad. David writhing around in pain. Gordy back to the Orient. That must be where he picked this up. There's Roberts out there. As Gordy continues. Some kind of weird sleeper hold that involves the thumb in some way. And Jerry Usher asking Gordy what he's doing. He has left David lying in the ring and is now yelling and taunting him.
Gone
in the second fall. Terry Gordy with a headbutt. Gordy has come back in control. He must win this to draw even. And he has just done so. Whatever that is he does, it works.
5 minutes and 5 seconds. The winner of the second fall, Terry Gordy. That's one fall each.
So we are all even. After one fall, the third fall will be the deciding fall, and we'll be back for it
right after this.
Custom-built energy home.
Magna versus the Iceman. Buddy Roberts versus Gentleman Chris Adams for the television title. The Mongo versus Mike Reed. Gordy and Hayes, Kerry and Brody, all four men in the ring at the same time. Monday night, Will Rogers Coliseum, 8 o'clock. We'll see you there. Now for the third and deciding fall in our Texas Heavyweight Championship. Durant's back with you as Chris Adams has joined us at ringside.
Third fall.
Winner of this fall wins the bout, and Chris, what a night we are experiencing.
I know, and what a fantastic match this is, Mark. You know, I'm really surprised that Gordy actually, what is this? Wow, David's coming back now. Look at this.
I don't know what that is he's using.
What is this thumb that he's got, this spike thing? This
looks
is
like some kind of sleeper that he uses that thumb with, but whatever it is, it works.
Really, it looks bad.
Gordy climbing up to the very top rope. Down he comes. And Gordy may be on his way to a big victory here. Now he's mad at the referee. And can you imagine a Freebird with the Texas Heavyweight Championship?
Really, I hope this never happens. David's just got to take it easy and try and recuperate slowly, and then maybe he can get the claw on Gordy, and I hope he can, Mark.
Boy, your success continues in the television title quest for the 5,000.
That's right. I'm on 4,000 now. I've got two more to go, and after two more weeks... Oh, yes, David's coming back now. Come on, Dave.
David's still a little bit dazed. Gordy's got him again. High in the air. David turns the tables, drops him down right across the knee. The atomic grab by David Von Erich. But Gordy with a foot in the face.
Gordy is a very, very strong and very powerful player, you know, and David is too, and I'm sure if David can just recuperate a little bit, he's going to show Gordy affinity.
Well, we've seen these Freebirds wound up like never before tonight. David to the ropes, back, and both men stagger and fall.
Gordy's out the ring. Hey, Gordy, hey!
Adams may need the...
Listen, Gordy, I'll concentrate on talking on the TV. You concentrate on wrestling in the ring, okay? And I'll tell you what, your friend Buddy Roberts shouldn't be here either.
Chris Adams minding his own business here at the table. And Gordy decided to pick up another opponent. Head over the rope as Buddy Roberts looks on. Look out. Roberts has jerked the chair out from under Chris Adams, and here they go. This is unbelievable. Two bouts going on, one inside, one outside the ring. Adams has got Roberts. Gordy is at work on David. Now Roberts has got Adams, who never intended for any of this to happen. He's got Gordy. He's got him turned. Hey!
In 4 minutes, 23 seconds, the winner of the third fall, and still the Texas heavyweight champion, David Von Erich.
Well, Buddy Roberts, when he grabbed Chris Adams and tied him up, thought he was going to distract and get Gordy to come over there and take care of Adams. And that's what Gordy wanted to do. But David Von Erich came over, taking advantage of Terry being distracted. Took him down for the 1-2-3 and is once again the Texas heavyweight champion.
Time limit. It
introducing first the challengers from Lake Dallas, the Fabulous Von Erich brothers, Kevin, David, and Kerry. And also introducing at this time another one of the Fabulous Von Erichs, who will be making his wrestling debut sometime a little bit later in the year. And Papa Von Erich says that he's so far the best of all of the amateurs. So here we introduce Michael Von Erich. You'll see him in the ring sometime later on this year. And now introducing the six-man world tag team champions, the Freebirds, Michael Hayes, your referee.
The six-man title of the world on the line here at the Tarrant County Convention Center in Fort Worth as Jerry Usher brings the trophy out. The Freebirds, the defending champions, against the challenging Von Erichs, all dressed up in their finest ring wear. And Joe Ranelli introducing Michael Von Erich, the youngest of the wrestling Von Erichs, and according to Fritz, he has as much or even more talent than any of his brothers, and we'll look forward to him making his debut sometime between now and the end of the year. A very talented, if not the most talented, up-and-coming Von Erich, Michael Von Erich. And a tremendous cheer from the crowd came up when his name was introduced. The six-man world title, Kerry, Kevin, and David Von Erich against Gordy, Hayes, and Buddy Roberts. This all started on Christmas Day of 1982 at Reunion Arena in Dallas. A very different set of Freebirds were wrestling for the world title. A late plane necessitated David Von Erich to fill in for Buddy Roberts. It was David who got the 1-2-3 and won the belt for the Freebirds, only to see the Freebirds turn around and become what we know them as currently. And since then, it's been warm. The Von Erichs won the six-man title at a very opportune time back in the early part of the summer of 1983. Right here in the same building. The Freebirds later won it back. And now Kerry Von Erich at work trying to get it back for the Von Erichs. This is bound to be a wild and heated event. The six-man belt, the second most prestigious title in all of the world, behind the World Heavyweight Championship. Gordy belts Kerry. And it's Gordy, the legal man, in against Kerry Von Erich. God, look at Kerry throw Gordy over. What tremendous strength in his arms. Leg scissors, but Gordy throws him off. You will be noticing that Freebird Buddy Roberts is wearing a headgear. Here's David in now. He really pounds Gordy into the rope. And here comes Roberts in wearing that headgear. It has been assumed that that headgear, the last time these six men met and won the belt for the Freebirds by having that headgear loaded with some lead or steel in there. The Tarrant County Convention Center is packed with a crowd of about 15,000 people, every seat taken, and they are really making noise. A beautiful building, this all part of a fabulous card which they have been enjoying for quite some time. There's Buddy Roberts with that headgear. Over and down goes Roberts, and it's the iron claw to midsection by David Von Erich. That patented Von Erich iron claw, there's no other like it. Here comes Hayes, here comes Kevin. not legal, he will leave. Now it's Gordy trying to come in. Roberts leaves. Hayes around David. Flying mare, clean tag. In comes Kerry, the modern day warrior. He wants Hayes. He's got him. Talent of the Von Erichs, and hear us speak of Michael Von Erich, you know what is in store, another superstar. There's Hayes coming off the ropes with a kick in the midsection, and carries over on the far side. Down. Michael Hayes with that long blonde hair, the symbol of the Freebirds. Here's Kevin moving in. Roberts has Kerry. Roberts is standing on the floor. Roberts now with the arm twisted on Kerry Von Erich. Slam by Terry Gordy. Gordy on Kerry with a tremendous right. Now it's Kerry slamming Gordy. Kerry climbs the ropes. Down to the elbow. Here comes Hayes, look out. David, I think he had a tag. Yes, he did. No, the referee said no, I wasn't sure, and evidently he didn't. Hayes throws Kerry into the headgear on Roberts. Right there. And Hayes wants a quicker count to Kerry. I'm sorry, who threatens the name? The face while Roberts held on to Kerry. Here's Roberts in now. He wants to slam. Kerry instead drops him over the knee. And look at Kerry throw Buddy off. Listen to this crowd. From 10 feet in the air. Across, Roberts hits hard and shakes the ring. Kevin charges and the leg scissors over and down. High flying Kevin Von Erich, so very adept and talented with those legs. Double knees and Roberts crashes. A triple drop kick, Von Erich style. No other wrestling team in the world will show you such excitement. And Gordy is around to the Von Erich side of the ring looking for trouble. So much water has gone under the bridge in the six-man situation, and it's all been boiling. Flying air. Kevin with the leg scissors around the midsection. Kevin with many friends in the Far East in the wrestling world, and he has gone to school with them on the art of the legs, and that's what we're seeing in this bout as he goes to work on that headgear. puts him down on the seat of his pants. Buddy Roberts trying to pin Kevin down as Kevin holds onto the leg scissors. There's a headbutt. And Kevin acts like he really was hurt, and that is supposed to be cushioned there. Could it be loaded again? They're holding on to him. Here's Gordy trying to come, but Kerry rushes in. Kevin nails him, and here comes Gordy. Across the rope, Gordy drops him right in the throat. David threatening Gordy, Kevin down, Kerry still in the ring. Four of the 5 men involved, now all 6 of them involved. They've got Kevin over there. Great coverage by our crew. There's Hayes at work outside on the apron. With an elbow, it's Buddy Roberts in a pin. Roberts from behind with a chin and head twist. And listen to the crowd chanting. First.
10 minutes.
The vicious Freebirds at work here, and here comes Kerry. Drop kick. Kerry spins as Gordy comes in and slams their heads together. Gordy falls all over the county. Gordy, iron claw on Hayes. Kevin and Kerry trying to remove the headgear on Roberts. There's Gordy outside. Indescribable. Gordy back in now. Kevin. Kevin all the way to the floor. And Gordy has gone to the floor again. Kerry has Roberts in the corner. David has Hayes in the ring. Kevin's going after Gordy. Hayes down and out. Kerry Gordy has got the Oriental spike on Kerry Von Erich. With the thumb and the throat, it's the Oriental spike. Kevin Von Erich with the iron claw on Michael Hayes. Buddy Roberts in a daze. David comes over, being pushed away by the referee for being the illegal man. Here comes Hayes, just barely moving. Kerry's been in the Oriental spike for about 25 seconds. Kevin knocks Hayes away. As Kevin and Hayes, Kerry still down. To the floor goes Hayes. Gordy now on Kevin. Kerry is still out. Here's the pin. 1, 2, 3. The Freebirds are our six-man champion. Michael Hayes, just a moment ago, down and out. But the Oriental Spike had carried down.
Now the winners of the match, the Freebirds win the match and are still the six-man World Tag Team Champions. You saw how it happened. The Freebirds win the match and keep the trophy and the championship.
Michael Hayes, down and out just a moment ago, was able to crawl over after Kerry had been in the vicious Oriental Spike by Terry Gordy and capitalized on the dirty work that Gordy did. And the Freebirds are six-man champions again. I'm Mark Lawrence at the Convention Center.
Don't you go to that little room till I finish telling you.